Okay, it runs. It sounds pretty good, considering what I started off with when it comes to this engine. I got a good one here. I gotta check the output on the charging system. The jumper pack should allow me to do that. I do want to add a gauge to the test stand eventually, so I can test charging. But there we go. So I gotta get a engine side wiring harness ordered. I'm gonna order that right now. As you can see, there's a bit of crap on the ground right there. That's from whenever I first started it up. It was literally dumping fuel straight through the other carburetor, straight down into the intake, and it was actually running that way. So it was basically running like a diesel would, but there was no control. The other carburetor was pretty bad. It could have been cleaned, but I had this one here. This one here was a known good carburetor, and I figured I might as well use it before it goes bad. I did end up having to RTV between here and here. There's a gasket here, then it has a spacer, then it's the RTV right there. I also added some RTV around here and here, just to make sure those gaskets do seal really good to these intakes. That's one issue with these cast intakes. They do leak occasionally around these points right here. I never touched this gasket right here, so I'd left that one completely alone. This gasket right here ripped, but the plastic piece was nice and clean. I cleaned up the carburetor. Yes, I used the wire wheel to clean up the carburetor because I'd already had this carburetor RTV'd to the intake that this was on. This one was on a plastic intake before, and again, the plastic ones do leak quite a bit as well. I do recommend a small layer of RTV, but I'd done that quite a few years ago. This carburetor came off of an engine I junked a long time ago, 4 or 5 years ago. So I wasn't in the best place whenever I put that one together, so I kind of overdid the RTV on that. So, but there we go. Let's choke it. I believe choke is on. Yes, it is. Now let's fire it up once more and see how it starts. Definitely runs good. So the plan will be to put this engine into the Free Craftsman, basically the way it sits. I won't wait until I have gaskets or anything like that, wiring harness. I will do it right away, just so I can get it in, get it mounted, and I can actually test run it in that machine. I can even get the top cover just sitting in place. I'll order up a new air filter for it. I have actually a set of plugs. I found a set of brand new plugs for one of these engines, so I'm going to slap them in. They actually came with this carburetor right here, but I never used them. So good on that one. I also had a brand new intake gasket to go between the intake here and the carburetor. Also came with this carburetor originally, because I bought this carburetor brand new off eBay. Just never really used everything from the kit. So anyways, I'm happy I was able to save this carburetor. The original carburetor that was on here will probably just go in the trash. They're so cheap now, they're not worth saving. They're not worth fixing or cleaning, stuff like that. I just got lucky I had this one here. I remembered it was a known good carburetor, so I used it. So that's the only reason why I did not order up a new one for this engine. And the whole name of the game here is doing it as cheap as possible. Again, free tractor, going to get everything put together as cheap as possible and make it work. So I'm going to get the charging system checked. I'll probably post it in the description below if it's charging or not. Because if it's not charging, we're going to have to dig deeper into this engine. But if it is charging, we are pretty well good to go. And yes, that's the original fuel line. It's not leaking, so I'm leaving it. So I'll talk to them later. Please keep it redneck like always, and please subscribe and comment.